Hello and welcome to my EGU 2020 display on the detection of oxidized and highly oxidized organic molecules by Caron PTRMS via ammonium adduct ionization. I want to start this display with a quick motivation. Oxidized and highly oxidized molecules are important target compounds in atmospheric aerosol. They define the phase and the production of the aerosol. And Caron PTRMS is able to detect these compounds at sub-nanogram per cubic meter concentrations in real time. And as H3O plus reaction wines react with all oxidized organics at unit efficiency, we can therefore measure these compounds quantitatively. There is one drawback. Oxidized functional groups are often ejected upon proton transfer reaction, and this, for example, leads to a loss of neutral water. Therefore, we have developed a fragmentation correction algorithm, and this algorithm is needed for quantitative results, including total organic mass concentrations, elemental analyses, or bulk chemical compositions. But there are also other possibilities to measure without a lot of fragmentation, and one of these possibilities is the soft adduct ionization with ammonium ions. And when we ionize our molecules with ammonia at very soft ionization settings of only 30 to 60 Townsend, this leads predominantly to an ammonium adduct formation. And the important thing is, with this adduct formation, almost the entire chemical composition of the analyte is conserved. And as an example, I've plotted here the mass spectrum of levoglucosan in ammonium mode, and there is only one single peak visible, namely C6H10O5 clustered with the ammonia. There are no fragments, and there are no dimers or other clusters visible. But we did not measure only levoglucosan, we actually measured a set of 17 oxidized and highly oxidized molecules in H3O plus and in soft ammonia mode. And actually only a very small subset shows ionic fragmentation or follows to a fraction and alternative ionization pathway, for example protonation. And this is visible in the two figures below. For example, here on the left side I've plotted the expected number of carbons versus the measured number of carbons of all 17 measured compounds, and as you see, most compounds very well follow the one-to-one line. There are only a few exceptions, like dichromyl peroxide, a compound that is already known to thermally degradate at 65 degrees Celsius. And to the right side, I've plotted the O2C measured versus the O2C expected, again in NH4 plus mode. Nearly all compounds follow very well the one-to-one line. There are again a few exceptions like fructose or cumene hydroperoxide that shows a slight degree of fragmentation. Now we know that we can measure this more oxidized and highly oxidized molecules almost fragmentation free, but can we also quantify these molecules? And one thing we have to know is that the reaction weight is less defined than for example, proton transfer reactions with hydronium ions. And this collisional limit that we typically have for the proton transfer reaction is only the upper limit for our ionization efficiency. And typically, most of the time, it follows a reduced effective reaction weight constant. And very recently, Zaitsev et al. In 2019 introduced as a parametrization for this reaction weight constant based on bond energies of the molecule and the ammonium adduct cluster. And this parametrization is plotted here as the red dotted line. In the x-axis you see the bond energies, and on the y-axis something proportional to the collisional weight. So at 0. EV we have no response, and at 0.19 EV ionization follows the reaction, the collisional limit. And we also know from literature that steric factors will also affect sensitivities. And now, when we look at our data, we see that most compounds actually follow the parameterization suggested by Zaitsev et al. By a factor 2, but there are also some compounds that show slightly reduced responses, like phthalic acid or dichromyl peroxide, and this is likely to steric factors. Now we know that we can detect oxidized molecules without hardly any fragmentation, and we can do that almost quantitatively. So let's have a look at a real-world example. And here I'm going to show you, as an example, secondary organic aerosol produced by the ozonolysis of pure limonene vapor. And here we see two mass spectra on the left side measured in H3O plus mode and on the right side measured in soft ammonium adduct mode. And it's immediately visible when you compare both mass spectra that fragmentation is highly reduced in the soft ammonium mode. And it's best visible here when we look at the dimer range that is much more pronounced in ammonium mode. In ammonium mode, we also see one dominant ion, namely C9H14O4, clustered with ammonium, and that is likely limonic acid. When we now look at the chemical compositions of both modes, so H3O plus and ammonium mode, and apply the parametrization by Zaitsev et al. To the ammonium mode and the fragmentation correction introduced by Liglis et al., we actually see the same neutral bulk chemical composition of around C9H13 or 3.3. Now let's look in a little more detail into the ion distribution or in ammonium mode. And to the right side, I've plotted the number of oxygen versus the relative intensities, color-coded to the number of carbons. And again, as we see, most compounds have 4 number of oxygens and 5 to 9 carbons. So this includes, for example, limonic acid that was the dominant ion in the mass spectrum. But also very visible is that we can detect up to 7 oxygens in molecules of the monomer region and up to 8 oxygens in molecules of the dimer region. And even if we look into more detail, we can see that almost all major reported limonene secondary aerosol products can be directly identified and, of course, in ammonium mode, quantified with an accuracy of a factor 2. And this already brings me to my conclusion. We have presented a new ionization mode for the characterization of oxidized and highly oxidized molecules using ammonium primary reagent ions. And actually, we can produce this ammonium primary reagent ions in the hollow cathode of our ion source at high purity without the need of injection of any form of pure or diluted ammonia. The injection of pure water vapor and pure nitrogen is enough. We have demonstrated that almost fragmentation-free adduct formation is the dominant ionization pathway for oxidized molecules. And these oxidized molecules include highly oxidized molecules with numbers of oxygen up to 8 and otherwise highly fragmenting compounds like peroxides. And also a quantification is possible based on a parameterization of the bond energies with the molecules, but the errors are likely higher compared to the ones of the H3O plus mode. And with that, I want to thank you for your attention.